जय हिंद, जय भारत, जय माता दी। आई एम थर्ड ऑफिसर जसविंदर सिंह, फाउंडर ऑफ जीएस फ्लीट, एन इनिशिएटिव टू गाइड एंड ट्रेन यंग डेक कैडेट्स टू बिकम फ्यूचर डेक ऑफिसर्स। सो इन दिस वीडियो वील बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द फुल एग्जाम पैटर्न ऑफ सेकेंड मेट्स एग्जाम्स। सो स्टार्टिंग ऑन, सो फर्स्टली वी हैव द सिक्स रिटन्स एंड फॉलोड बाय थ्री ओरल एग्जाम्स। सो इन द सिक्स रिटन्स यू कैन सी हियर, दीज आर ऑल द रिटन पेपर्स: terrestrial and coastal navigation, bridge equipment and watch keeping, cargo handling and storage, celestial navigation, meteorology, ship construction, stability, ship safety and environment protection. And after you clear your written exams, then you can apply for the three orals or the three functions. And in that, the function one is navigation, function two is cargo handling and storage, and function three is controlling the operations of the ship and care of persons on board. So the writtens are conducted all over India on the same day, like it's conducted every month, and then it's conducted all over India. The exam paper is same and it's conducted on the very same day, and you have to go and visit the MMD to give these exams. You can't give it anywhere else, so you have to go to the MMD and give your written exams. And all the written exams are mostly conducted of consecutive days, so it's more likely that even in 1 week you can finish all your writtens, or max to max in 10 days your writtens will be finished, and then you can start with your orals. So the orals or the functions, so all three orals are usually conducted on the very same day. That's right guys, and orals are very tough, so you have to prepare a lot for that. You have to practice with your friends, you have to do group discussions for that, because speaking in front of anyone is not that easy. In writtens, it's easy because you have practiced the diagrams, and mostly the written exams are much easier to clear. But in the orals, it's quite tough because their examiners are going to cross question you on your answers. In writtens, you are just going to write everything, but in the orals, you have to speak very carefully. Okay, so in the three orals that are conducted on the same day, so there will be an internal and external examiner, and we'll be talking about the online mode and offline mode. So in the earlier days, what used to happen was, so you used to go to the MMD, and there were two examiners. Basically, one was internal and one was external examiner. But now this is no more valid. Now there is something known as online mode and offline mode. So in the online mode, you will be facing everything from your home only. So if you apply for the online mode, you can give the orals by sitting at your home on your PC. The examiner will be connected, and firstly the external examiner will come, he will ask you some questions, and then he will transfer your marks to the internal examiner, and then the internal examiner will again ask you some questions, and then he will finalize your result. But in the offline mode, you are eliminating the possibilities of your internet connection, and you are going to the MMD to give your exams. But here also there will be a PC, a dedicated PC on which you will sit down, and an external examiner will come online and he will ask you question. And then the internal examiner, he can also take face to face orals, or sometimes he might also come on online mode. So you have to decide which mode you want, the online mode or the offline mode. In the online mode, you can give the exams by sitting at your home, but in the offline mode, it's much easier. I would say you sometimes get to face the internal examiner face to face, and moreover, you are eliminating the connectivity or internet connection problems. So I would prefer, if you have time, then please do visit the MMD and give your oral exams in the offline mode. Then moving on, luck factor here is a very big factor, I would say, because sometimes it may happen, like let's say you are giving in online mode, sometimes it may happen that okay, your internet connection has gone, then your attempt is gone, you can't reconnect again, and then he's not going to ask you again. So luck is an important factor. Although in offline mode also there is luck, because the MMD surveyors, whoever is coming, so you don't know who is coming to take your orals. So he might come from Chennai, he might come from Mumbai MMD. So in the earlier past days, we used to know, okay, at least if you are giving in Noida, let's say, so you know there are 5-6 surveys, so every cadet used to prepare his survey sets and go. But right now, in this current period of time, you don't know which surveyor will come, from which state he will come, from where. you are just sitting there randomly, so you have to prepare accordingly, you have to prepare thoroughly for that. There is no more concept of survey sets now. Anyone can come and he can ask you any question. Okay, so yeah, so now we'll be talking about the passing marks. So in the writtens, the TCN is the terrestrial and coastal navigation. The passing marks are 140 out of 200. Then bridge watchkeeping and equipment is 100 out of 200. Then cargo handling and stowage, 120 out of 200. Celestial navigation, 140 out of 200. Meteorology, 50 out of 100. Ship construction, stability and all, 120 out of 200. And then if we come on to our orals, the passing marks for function 1 is 70%. For function 2 and 3 is 60%. So he's not going to ask you for like, he's not going to ask you 100 questions. He's going to ask you just 10 questions for each function. And in case you are able to answer 6 or 7, accordingly, he will pass you. So the most important thing here is to impress your external examiner. So once he's coming, you have to be very confident in your answers. First impression is the last impression, guys. So you have to give your first answer as if you are well prepared. And don't just surrender yourself even before the exam starts, because there are few candidates who get nervous on the examination day and they tell the surveyor, okay, we have booked all three functions, but I would not like to, you know, attempt function 2 today or function 1 today and I am not prepared. If you surrender yourself even before the start of examination, then it's not a good sign, because you need to trust yourself, because you have completed your required sea time on board. He might ask you only practical questions which you have studied on board, which you have practically experienced on board, and that can be a savior for you guys. It does not matter that your technical knowledge is that strong or not, but in case your practical knowledge is strong and he feels that you have got the required knowledge, he might pass you. So you have to work accordingly, you have to prepare accordingly, and you have to focus on both the things, technical and practical. Depends on surveyor to surveyor how he is going to ask you. Okay, moving ahead. So how to prepare? For the writtens, writtens are comparatively easier if you compare it with the orals. So for the writtens, you have to only prepare last 10 year, past year papers, and you have to prepare it topic wise. So let's say you are preparing for meteorology. Once you open the meteorology paper, you will understand by seeing the questions. Okay, first topic is from this chapter, second topic is from this certain chapter. So you have to prepare it topic wise. Writtens are much easier to prepare. So for the writtens, you can easily get the past year papers on Marinepedia app. This is an app which is available on Android devices. So you can get it on the Marinepedia app. And for the orals, guys, trust me, you will have to study everything, because right now the situation is quite bad. Surveyors are coming from anywhere, so you have to study the full syllabus. And I have made my own book, which is like a guide, a master guide, completing each and every subject. It consists of each and every subject in just one book. So let's say function 1 is consisting of 10 to 12 subjects. So you don't have to take all the books. You can just take my book, study from that, and hopefully you will be able to clear your oral exams. So right now my function 3 book is ready and you can buy it by the link in the description. Function 2 book is almost ready and will be available by the next week, and then I'll be working on function 1 also. So in case you are interested in buying the ebooks or the hard copies, you can contact me by the link in the description, or you can contact me on my WhatsApp. I will drop my WhatsApp number also in the description box below.
Just now you saw that a young third officer Jaswinder Singh has written this fabulous book, a great initiative taken for the maritime industry, and I just hope that Babaji Kripa, that he writes the other two books soon. And I'm just waiting that many more young people join and make sure that we give the right knowledge to the maritime fraternity. At one end, in the last 3 years, Merchant Navy Decoded has helped a lot of marine engineers and GP rating people with a lot of online content, which is helping them today earn respect on ship, whether it's related to how to read electrical circuit diagram, how to read manoeuvring diagrams, how does automation work, a lot of videos made on ship. Definitely, we lagged with the deck side packages, but now we have worked on that. So we have come along with packages on ROR. We have come along with packages on specifically made for candidates who are about to join their first ship as a deck cadet, and many more. why don't you just go to the link given in the description box and the pinned comment and see for yourself what all packages are available and how are they beneficial to you. Let's make a strong maritime community which is out there to earn respect, ownership and make Indian maritime fraternity proud. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat, Jai Mata.